Hello and welcome to today's Facecast. Today we are in the New Testament letter of St. Paul to the church in Corinth. So it's the first letter to that church, 1 Corinthians chapter 13, which is a famous passage of scripture. It's the passage of scripture that's most often read at weddings because it's all about love and what love is and how important love is in our lives. And in chapter 13, verse 3, it says this: "If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames, but have not love, I gain nothing." That's quite a statement, isn't it? If I surrender my body to the flames, if I give everything I possess to the poor, if I give away everything that I have and do a good thing by giving it to the poor, if I sacrifice myself, but if I don't do it through love, if I don't do it with love, and if I don't do it as a result of love in my life, then there's nothing gained, because, he's saying, love is everything. And that passage goes on to outline all the things that love is and that love isn't. We use just that one word, love, to cover a whole range of feelings and emotions and actions. In different languages, in the Greek, for example, they're all different words that mean love and display a whole variety of things. We know that's true of other words in other languages too. So we sometimes have to borrow from those languages in order to appreciate and understand what it is and the width and depth of what we're talking about. And as it is with that word love. But what Paul is really saying is that everything should be motivated by the love that we have in our hearts for our fellow man and for ourselves and for our Father in heaven. And it's a love displayed to us by Jesus, his very presence with us, his attitude to us, his teaching to us. And if we don't have that love in our lives, that deep-seated, deep-rooted love for ourselves and for God and for one another, if we don't have that, then, well, everything else is meaningless because we're just trying to get by, just trying to make life happen until we breathe our last breath. So I commend to you this morning to revisit what love you have and what love, more importantly, you can give to others. Because that's how love starts. It's with what we give to other people. That's how love starts, and then it is returned to us in manifold ways that we could never even have imagined. I commend to you the way of love, as mentioned here and the rest of the scriptures. This is 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 3. Read the whole chapter and see what it says to you about love in our world today. Well, have a good... Sorry, what was that? Why am I wearing a bow tie and a dress shirt? It was a very late night. See you soon.